National Infrastructure Condition Performance Measures. Federal transportation performance management rules that became effective in 2016 and 2017 are designed to guide investment of public funds by using data for better informed decision making and ensuring accountability and transparency. The rules include performance measures for the nation's highway infrastructure. This video covers how the infrastructure performance measures are used, what the measures assess, and why certain other measures were excluded. How infrastructure performance measures are used. Six national infrastructure performance measures assess the condition of pavement and bridge assets on the National Highway System, NHS, both on the interstate and non-interstate systems. The purpose is to ensure that federal aid fund investments help achieve the goals of the state's asset management plan. What the measures assess. Four of the six measures assess the percentage of pavements in good or poor condition. Two of these four measures focus on the interstate system, while the other two focus on the non-interstate NHS. In addition, there are two bridge condition performance measures that assess the percentage of NHS bridges in good or poor condition by deck area. These six measures are system-level measures. While individual sections of pavement and individual bridges deteriorate slowly, changes to the overall system can be identified more quickly. During the development of these measures, FHWA examined historic pavement and bridge condition trends and found noticeable changes over 2-year and 4-year periods. This analysis confirmed that meaningful changes to the system can happen in short periods. The establishment of 2-year and 4-year targets for the infrastructure condition measures could be considered objectives that lead toward the accomplishment of longer-term performance expectations in state DOT, long-range statewide transportation plans, and asset management plans. What was not included and why? The FHWA made a few decisions to focus the scope of these six national measures. For example, FHWA excluded traffic volume from the pavement condition performance measures. The FHWA believes incorporating traffic volume could unintentionally cause state DOTs and MPOs to focus on high-trafficked highway sections. Instead, FHWA believes local partners should determine if and how to incorporate traffic volumes into their decision-making. Another critical decision was to not include fare as a pavement condition measure. The FHWA believes the net increase or decrease of percent of the network in fare condition does not easily indicate improving or declining condition. For example, if there were an increase in the percent of pavement sections assessed to be in fare condition, it could be a result either of previously good conditions declining or previously poor conditions improving. Instead, FHWA believes that focusing only on good and poor conditions will better indicate improvement or decline of network condition. For bridges, although the classification of bridges in fair condition and its calculation are in the regulations, state DOTs and MPOs are not required to establish or report on performance targets for the fair classification. However, it is expected that states will monitor and manage the percentage of assets within all three classifications, good, fair, and poor. Finally, data reporting systems were a major influence on the selection of these six national infrastructure performance measures and their associated metrics. FHWA's partners were familiar with submitting pavement metric data to the Highway Performance Monitoring System, HPMS, and bridge metric data to the National Bridge Inventory, NBI database. Incorporating new metric data reporting requirements into established workflows was deemed an efficient solution. For additional information on how to implement the infrastructure condition performance measures, contact your local FHWA division office and visit www.fhwa.dot.gov/TPM. For a more detailed discussion on how these measures were selected and weighed against stakeholder input, you may review the summary and discussion of comments in the final rule. Links to all the TPM-related rulemakings are at www.fhwa.dot.gov/TPM/rule.CFM. Download the companion resource with helpful citations and other information at www.fhwa.dot.gov/TPM/videos. Working together, we can provide strategies to improve our nation and people's lives through great transportation planning.